What's up, Star Wars fans, and welcome to my review of Star Wars The Clone Wars Season 5, Episode 10, Secret Weapons. So I'm going to be talking about what I liked and disliked about the episode, and I'm going to be showing you what I'm talking about on the screen. So, I think, you know, the blue opening logo, it's a tribute to R2-D2, because he's just so awesome. But I think it's unnecessary. You know, for the Maul arc, they had the red logo. That was cool, and that was it was a tribute to Maul, and that was cool because it was really necessary because, like, Maul, like, he's reborn now, he's in the Clone Wars again, but, like, just because there are episodes that also focus, like, where R2-D2 is one of the main characters, you have to have a blue, I don't know, that's a little too exaggerated, but that's just my opinion. So, the episode was better than I expected from the previews, but that doesn't mean it's, I thought it was great. I mean, it was, the storyline was fine, but there was a lot of unnecessary talking and so, but it was fine, and I hope this is, like, only a two, because, like, in the season, we haven't had, like, in the trailer, there were Mandalorians, there were Ventress, there were, like, even more Maul stuff, there were Bounty Hunters, the Embo clip, the Clovis arc, like, where has that been? Now it's, like, just, I hope this is only a two-part. It will be another episode, I can guarantee you, because in one, IGN showed us one clip of Star Wars The Clone Season 5, with the Gregor clone, the guy who just finds out he's a clone somehow, lost his eye, like, he's like the Jason Bourne guy of the clones, and he's a clone commando. So, maybe it'll only be two episodes, or three, because, like, the Clone Wars guys, Dave Filoni, likes to make a lot of arcs, so, well, I just hope this is only two episodes, because I really can't stand the droids for four episodes. That's just no. Okay, then Commander Neo appeared at the start. He, you may know him from Revenge of the Sith. And his helmet is very unique, and it's called a Coliseum. And I think he also serves, like, or is the Master? Oh, crap. I forgot to remember. But he's somehow associated with the whack guy, with the pit droid. Okay, then, speaking about whack, the whack guy is completely annoying. Like, why did they have to bring him in? Jeez. Okay, then the next guy who I don't like is Dr. Gubacker, or however he's pronounced. You know, the Parwan that upgrades all the droids. And it's like he's just weird. He's like a mad scientist. He's like, ugh, he's just creepy. Okay, then, cool that there is another super tactical droid in the season. Like, we also someone posted that, like, I don't know, was it Star Wars .com officially, but we'll get to see more, super tactical droids after General Kalani in the Onderon arc appeared. So, is this the last guy? But it can't be, actually. Because in the trailer there is one super tactical droid in, like, the second trailer, like the 3:30 trailer of season 5, Count Dooku speaking to a super tactical droid in person, not a hologram. So here, that will be another episode. Maybe it will even be destroyed. He'll get reassembled and it's him, but at least there's another appearance of a super tactical droid in this season. Then, it's cool to see new Astromax and also, okay, that pit droid, whack, in action. And at the start, you can see, I don't know if you noticed, but, like, the Jedi, they're all their masters. You see, I have no idea, except for that Anakin is R2's master, but they're, like, they're Master Sunuba, Isla Secura, they're all the masters from these droids. And this episode just proves that, like, separatist droids are just plain stupid. Like, they have no brain. They're like, get out of the way, Astromax. And they don't even know if there are any life forms. I mean, they scan for life forms. There are no life forms. And then, like, they're just random Astromax appearing on a separatist ship. Like, legit, okay. Okay, yeah, that was already it for this episode. This episode wasn't very exciting. That's why I don't have a lot of points to tell you about if I like them or dislike them, but my rating of this episode is a 6, maybe a 5 or a 6 out of 10, I don't know. Yeah, it was fine, the storyline was fine, and I didn't really like the general How is he called again? Colonel. No, that's how the white guy calls him. Corporal, I don't know. Yeah, that general was a little weird to have him as the sort of actually guy in charge for the mission. But, yeah, the rest of that episode wasn't really good either. But I'm really looking forward to that episode with the Clone Commander Gregor in it. Maybe that'll even be next episode. And next episode is called A Sunny Day in the Void. So that, that is really random for the droid thing, but... Okay, so that was my review, basically, and if you liked it, please subscribe, like, and comment, and thank you for watching, and see you next week, bye!